Hi everyone, I'm Kasia Bosnę, wardrobe stylist, fashion bajonista, founder of Boutique on 57. And in today's video, I am going to take you to my closet, which as you can see, it's a little bit messy, but considering that it's a change of season, it's a little bit mixed between the seasons because it's one day it's hot, one day it's cold. So I'm going to take this opportunity to organize and well edit my closet, and I'm going to show you that there is really five simple rules to really keep it nice and organized and very easy to use. So the first rule, which is the most important in my opinion, is using right hangers. Hangers can really save enormous amount of space for you. And I found those very popular velvet hangers by Karim Rhodes that you can get in Amazon, that you can get in Container Store, Bath Bath & Beyond, in any other store that sells hangers, because they have different categories, different colors. Like in my closet, I like to keep everything uniform. Nice black color serves, works for me. And they have a fantastic pant hangers and jackets and your tops and dresses hangers. Get rid of those dry cleaning hangers that I'll show you I have in the closet. They are really distracting in your closet and they really look chaotic and they are not giving you that nice uniform look that we are looking for in the closet. Anything that also it's in a plastic, get rid of it, as I only put plastic on the clothes that are really easily wrinkled or they have some sequins, very delicate embroidery that can catch on another piece of clothing and can ruin it. This is an example of the hanger that would probably make your closet look very chaotic and would not give you this uniform look. So get rid of all of those iron hangers which are having paper on them. Get rid of the wooden hanger that take enormous amount of space. They are super heavy and you will be able to fit so much. You'll be actually very surprised how much you can fit. The second rule is to organize everything by the season. And even though this seems to be like not that much, believe me, I don't even use half of the stuff. I really try to concentrate on the items that I'm going to use that particular season. So if it's fall, if it's winter, if it's summer or spring, I only make sure that I have the clothes from that particular season that I will be using them that particular time of the year. So as you can see on my top shelf, I have all my winter boots and all the shoes and winter bags that I'm not going to use, so I just store them away. The rule number three is to have everything categorized. So like I have my pants first and my skirts, then on the bottom I have my tops and my sweaters and my jackets. Right on the side I have my dresses. Casual and evening cocktail dresses, and on this side I have some more delicate items that I separated, the ones that they wrinkle easily and they need extra protection in plastic. This method actually helped me to organize not only my closet but also in my business, where I organize all the wardrobe by the category. It helps me to save so much time and I right away visualize which section do I have to go to find particular item. It makes it so much more pleasurable and so much easier to find exactly what you're looking for. The rule number four, which has been working for me and my assistants in my business as well as in my closet, is to organize everything by the color. So once you have your categories in place, the next one I start with my favorite color selection. I start with white, then I go to creams and off-whites, then I go to light beiges, then I go to peaches and pinks, then I go to red, bright fuchsia, then I follow to purple, then from purple I go to light grays, darker grays, light blue, a little bit darker blue, navy blue, browns, and all my blacks. So if I ever get lost and I don't really know where's particular blouse, but I know the color, that's going to make it really easy to go to the right color, to the right section, and being able to find it. And this has worked for me, this has worked for so many people, and I'm sure that can work for you as well. The fifth very practical rule that I use is the Space Saver boxes. that I use from Container Store, made of canvas, very lightweight. They have a zipper on the top and they close with the Velcro, so it's really easy to open it, and I'll show you the inside. They really fit a lot of stuff. They're very lightweight, so you can store them easily away, put them on the shelf, and put the stuff that you don't need, or you can store whatever you need and you can use every single day. I use it to store my scarves and gloves and hats, tights, socks, undergarments, anything that I don't need. They come also in different colors. I particularly like the color gray, as that's one of my favorite colors. This particular size is about $40. I bought it on sale. The original price was like $49. I paid $39.99. But Container Store has a lot of different specials and deals, so you can just look for some promotions that they might have. And this I actually really, really love because it serves so many multiple purposes. It also looks really good. And so many friends of mine who saw this in my closet, they actually incorporated it right away in their own closet. And as you can see, I have them right on my side where I just store in a little smaller size. I store all my gloves and all my socks, and I'll show you the different compartments that I put inside to keep it nice and organized. Another great tip that you might find useful is to use any favorite scents in your closet. I like to use my favorite soaps that I get every year in France. They smell so delicious, and I don't use them to wash my hands, as I only like liquid gels or liquid soaps. But they are serving fantastic purpose to give this fantastic, fabulous, delicious aroma to my clothes. So each time I open my closet, it's really pleasant to just walk inside and really enjoy the beautiful scent of apricots. Also, it's great. I saw the front gate sells the travel size purifier, air purifiers, and they are very handy. You can travel with them. You can put them in few places and keep also fresh circulation of the air along with your favorite scent, and really enjoy and make it very special each time you dress. And of course, I have to talk about shoes, which they say they are best girls' friends. Some people like to keep them out of the boxes and have them right displayed. I'm very particular about my shoes, and this is just my personal way of displaying them. I like to keep them inside my boxes where I photograph them and put the shoe picture right outside. There's another solution which I found. You can also get in Container Store a very clear box. They come also in different shapes and sizes, and you could just store your shoes. So if you want to avoid photographing them, and it's really a nice, easy way and clean to keep them in those containers. So that's another solution for you. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you had fun. I hope I helped you to well edit your closet. If you have any suggestions, please let me know. If perhaps there is some more secrets to edit the closet even a better way, I'm always looking forward to hear from you. If you like the video, of course, please give me thumbs up, and I will see you very soon.